What's up, world? Dallas Thomas here with Gadget Hacks. Today I'm going to show you 5 new and under-the-radar Android apps from indie devs. Now, I'm always scrolling through forums and Reddit and release sites looking for apps that solve a problem. It's what I do. When I find one, I write an article about it and maybe make a video. And it's always framed as how to solve XYZ problem. But a lot of the apps I find can't be covered that way. They don't necessarily solve a problem that would merit a how-to guide. Instead of just scrolling past those, now I'm going to start jotting them down and giving them a little test drive so I can show them to you guys in case you're interested. These are almost always apps by independent developers. Just one person working out of their home with a dream of making it big in the Android community. So let's shine a light on those indie apps, right? The first one I have for you is called Bootiful. It's a root app and it requires Magisk, but it lets you change your phone's boot animation like it was your wallpaper. What you do is install the app and then download a boot animation you like. Then you just go to the module section in Magisk Manager and hit install from storage to flash the boot animation you downloaded. It doesn't work with every phone, and so far I know it doesn't work with Galaxy or Pixel devices, but the developer is actively adding support. So check it out on the Play Store. As with all these, you'll find the download link in the description below. Now the second app is called Photo Ranker. It's a bit out there, but you might find a good use for it. The goal is to find your best profile pic to use for dating services. You upload pictures of yourself, and the other users of the app will vote on them to tell you which one is the best. But you give the app your target audience first, so if your goal is to find a female companion, you'd say that. Then the app will only show your pictures to female users for ranking. Like I said, it's a bit wild, but the dev says if you give it a day, even with the currently small user base, you should get around 40 votes, so give it a try. Up third is an app called NoScene. What it does is let you read WhatsApp messages without sending read receipts to the other user. In other words, you can read messages without letting the other person know you've seen them yet. Basically, you keep the standard version of WhatsApp installed and you install this alongside it. Then new messages will appear in both WhatsApp and NoScene. So if you want to read a message without it automatically being marked as read, just open NoScene to read it there. I will say though, another app called Ghosted by Small Bro Tech is very similar and has been around for a while. So if you're not feeling NoScene, that's a solid alternative. Then the fourth app is called Teo. This one's actually been out for a few months, but it keeps flying under the radar. In one sentence, it's a photo editing app with a focus on teal and orange filters. Why? Because if you've noticed, that's the way almost every single modern movie is color graded. So it can definitely give your photos that cinematic look. The reason for teal and orange specifically is that all skin tones are in the orange range with various saturation and lightness. And as any color wheel will tell you, the opposite and thus complementary color to orange is teal. So what you do is you put an orange filter on your midtones to bring out those skin tones. Then you do teal on the highlights or shadows for a nice contrast in colors. It's color science, not just a trend, so you might as well get on board already and give it a try in your photos. Finally, there's Logomaker. I'd look at this kind of like a mobile-friendly version of Photoshop that focuses on making icons rather than adjusting pictures. There are 1,500 logo templates to start from. Pick one of those, add text, layer some stuff on top, and you got yourself a pro-quality icon made entirely on Android. But hey, for more cool apps like these, be sure to check out our website over at gadgethacks.com. And as always, we'd appreciate it if you would like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel. So we'll see you again next time, folks. But until then, happy gadget hacking.